On this episode, you'll learn how to use Feedly to read and share blog content and save yourself time. I'm Christian Karasevich from Social Chefs. Welcome to Social Snacks. Well, you'll learn social media marketing tips to grow your business in under 5 minutes. For those of you not familiar with Feedly, it's an RSS reader. Basically, you can take all of the blogs and websites you currently read and subscribe to and bring them into one application that's accessible from a desktop or a mobile device. It's also easy to share from. To get started, head to socialchefs.com/go/Feedly to sign up for a free account. Once you have your Feedly account set up, in the search box, type in the name of the website you normally read. Let's take a look now at some ways you can save time using Feedly to read and share content. So one way to save time in Feedly is to add your blogs to different categories. For example, we have ones for social media and content marketing, as well as competitors. And you can add a blog to multiple categories. You can even add one for email newsletters. So this leads us to another way to use Feedly. If you read a lot of email newsletters and your inbox is overflowing, you can create a category in Feedly and add all of the newsletters in Feedly without having to subscribe to them. This way your inbox remains clean. A third way to use Feedly is to create hashtags from the categories. So for example, if I create a category called social media and then go to share it when I am on the mobile device, if I use, say, a service like Buffer, it will automatically add a hashtag of social media. So this is one less step you have to do. Speaking of social media, when you're going to add a blog that you read to Feedly, when you name it, don't use the name of the blog. Instead, use the name of the blog's Twitter account. For example, it could be @socialchefs. This way, when it's time to share content from that blog on Twitter, it's easy to do and you don't have to spend time going and looking up what that Twitter account's name is. Once you sign up for Feedly and you've downloaded the desktop app, we also recommend that you check out the mobile app as well. This is a very convenient way for you to use Feedly to read your news and share content when you're on the go. Another thing to do when you're learning how to use Feedly to read and share content is to learn the keyboard shortcuts. You can access these by simply pressing Shift? Inside of Feedly. Another powerful feature when learning how to use Feedly is tagging. Basically, you can go in and you can tag articles. This way, it's easy for you to view all of the content you want to view in one location. You can also use tagging with other services such as IFTTT and Zapier. Using Feedly isn't just a way to make it easy to read content, you can also share content across a variety of different social networks. You can add it to Buffer, Hootsuite, or use an email feature. Overall, it's a very convenient, time-saving tool. Another way that we love to use Feedly is with IFTTT, which we just mentioned. Now, this is really neat because you can combine a lot of these tips together. For example, you can set up a recipe in IFTTT that says when an article is tagged in Feedly with a certain keyword, have it automatically clipped to an Evernote notebook that you keep. The last thing to do when learning how to use Feedly is to add the Google Chrome Feedly subscribe extension. Now, this is very handy because if you're ever on any website and you want to add that blog or site to Feedly, all you have to do is click the extension that you set up in Google Chrome, and it will automatically add that to your Feedly account. Click the subscribe button below. If you have an idea, comment, or suggestion, leave those below as well. Go to socialchefs.com for fast professional training from leading social media professionals.